There's a law in Quebec preventing the million-plus non-French speakers from speaking their native language while at work.
Ottawa gets an unfair reputation as being, like people say that it's boring, and it's not boring. There's a ton of shit to do. If you find Ottawa boring, you are boring. I really enjoy Ottawa, and partly because I can understand you. Holy shit, I just spent 4 days in Montreal, and I have never, even today, I was running errands, and I needed envelopes, and I was like, okay, I'll just go, there's a Walmart, I'll go to a Walmart, and it's across the river, and I went to the Walmart. I have never expected to be given a dirty look for speaking English at a Walmart. But Quebec has that, horrifically xenophobic language law, where they're basically like, no, you must speak incorrect French. In order to live in Quebec, you have to speak the French that French people make fun of in order to live here. It's like Texas tried to do that with English, where Texas was like, oh, you can't speak Spanish or any other language, and a lot of people were like, no, that's horrifically xenophobic. And then Quebec was like, what if we do it with French? It's like, nope, still xenophobic. Telling someone they can't speak their native language at work is fucking ridiculous. Like, Quebec, I don't know if you know this, but Quebec is French Texas. Right down the secessionist movement, holy shit. And it's not just Quebec, you have parts of your country that are trying to leave all over the place. Which is so crazy, because all the Americans are like, can we come there? And then Canadians are like, can we go there? Not to America, that'd be fucking ridiculous, you guys don't want to get shot. But the point is that, like, there are parts of Alberta and Saskatchewan that want to secede as well, to make their own country of Alberta-Shawan or Saskatchewan-Berta, I don't know what they would call it. But it's not the cities, no. Calgary and Edmonton want to stay put, and Saskatoon and even Regina, that's a hilariously pronounced city. But they're all like, no, we don't want to secede, but these like rural areas are like, we're going to be our own country that has no people and produces nothing. And fucking go ahead. Best of luck to you. Especially to Quebec. Good luck being a country of 8 million people that borders America. See how safe you fucking feel. Anyway, it's good to be here. And I have truly loved, this is our last show on this stretch of the tour. It has been a crazy 6 weeks. The past couple of weeks have been all Canada. We started all the way in Vancouver. Could have given you a ride. We started all the way in Vancouver and drove across the entire country because fuck Air Canada. And it's been an amazing time. We did all kinds of crazy things, but I think my favorite moment happened. So in Montreal, we decided we were going to have we had a day off, we decided we were going to play a bunch of games, we were going to play laser tag. And I have never felt more of an advantage than being an American having to shoot at children. I'm sorry, but this is how we were raised, so. We won by a lot, but...
And then we closed the show with Leedy Corbin, a resident tour artist.
Quebec, Texas, Quebec.
Thank you for watching, following, subscribing, and sharing these videos. If you don't yet, make sure you follow me on TikTok, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and everything else. And of course, Patreon, where you can see videos like this before anyone, and one video a week, exclusively on Patreon. Patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. I'm back touring again, and I'm performing just about everywhere. All over America, Canada, Europe, Australia, New Zealand. everywhere. Okay, that's not everywhere, but it's a lot of places. Get your tickets and find out more at stevehofstetter.com.